I'm going to make a quick video here to explain the difference between using intersect with and contains list when doing a bubble filtering. So the example here, I'll show you two examples in the no code MBA site in progress here. So it's not finished, but it's in progress, and I wanted to show you how to do this. So here we have a browse page where you can browse all of the courses. And I'm just going to reload this. So here we have a list of categories. And if I choose data automation, it's going to now show data automation courses. And now if I click on e-commerce, you can see nothing is showing up because we are searching currently for any course or project that contains both e-commerce and data automation. So if I uncheck data automation, we'll see a couple e-commerce projects come up. So here, as you can see, we are searching for where the criteria matches all of our choices here. And if I go now to the homepage, let me just show you real quick here in the admin account. These are my categories, so let's say I just want to choose a few here: mobile app, membership, internal tools, updates. So that's my categories I just updated. If I go to the dashboard here, under recommended courses and recommended projects, we've set this up to show where any of those categories are chosen. So let me show you now what we did to do that. So if we go into our bubble app, the first thing that you should know is each user has a data type of categories, which is a list of categories here. And then we have our categories, which is just the name of the category. And then our courses also has a list of categories, and our project also has a list of categories. So these are the things that we're going to be filtering on. Okay, so if we go to the recommended courses here, so this is on the dashboard, the recommended courses, it's going to be the same for projects. We're searching for courses, so I want you to just kind of see the data source that we're searching with. So we're searching for courses. And then we have to use something called filtered and then advanced. So you use an advanced filter. And what we're going to do is this course's category intersects with the current user's categories. So, and this is going to check to see if any of the categories match. So we're going to show the course here as long as any of the categories match. So if it intersects with, we're going to count how many times it intersected. So here we're going to do greater than zero, which means that it intersected, any times. And if it does that, we're going to show. It's going to pass through this filter, and it's going to show the course. So this is how we show any filter, any matching course or project that meets the criteria of any of the categories. Now, let me go and show you the browse filter that we have. And here, what we're doing, just so you kind of can see, when someone chooses a category here, we're adding it as a custom state, a list of categories. You don't have to worry too much about that right now. The main thing is understanding the filtering that we're building. So here, if we go to our search for projects filtered, we're also doing an advanced filter. But here we're just doing contains list. So we're seeing if the projects category contains the list of the whole list we created of the filter category list category. So this is that list that we created with custom state. So contains list, this is what you need to know. This is when you are building a filter where you want the criteria to match every category or criteria in your list. So I'll go back real quick and show you one more time. In the dashboard, we're showing recommended courses that meet any of the criteria, any of the categories of our user. And if we go to browse, oops, and we select data automation, and mobile app. It's going, there's their, you know, and membership and internal tools. There's only one course that meets those, the No Code 101's course that has all of these categories. And there's no other projects or courses that meet that criteria. So it's going to look to match for all of the criteria you choose. Hope that's a helpful quick overview of the different type of advanced filtering that you can do in Bubble.